Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Today is Monday, July 24th, 2006. This is your daily video technical briefing. On the left, you have the British pound. On the right, you have the Euro USD. At the opening of the US session, a couple of things. Looks like price has been coming down, has found support, is on its way up, hit the 55 EMA, and is creating some sort of triangle on the pound. So we can do a couple of things. It's either a triangle or a channel. So let's connect the lows. Doesn't work so well. Let's connect that low on the bottoms. Okay. Actually, you know what? Let's go this low and grab the low on the bottom candle there. Okay. Now we could do a couple of different things. You could make this a triangle, or you can make it a channel. So let's make it a channel by making a parallel line. Oops, that didn't work. Let me try one more time. There we go. Okay. And as long as it's in the channel, it's an uptrend. And as soon as it breaks the bottom support line, it's a reversal. We're going to watch stochastics very closely for clues. We're also going to watch the euro for clues. We have a 5-8 crossing, which indicates up. First target would always be the 200 EMA. Okay, so let's take a look. Move a couple of clicks ahead on the pound, a couple of clicks ahead on the euro. Okay, ask yourself, what has changed? Well, the euro looks like it's overbought, just starting to roll over, losing angle and separation on the 5-8, but it's still pointing up. Looks like we're heading toward the 200 EMA. Look at the pound. The pound is much more interesting to me. I'll show you why. You can see the Bollinger Bands are actually closing and creating a top here. And stochastics have crossed and moved down right at the 25% line. And even though price has been in this up channel, you have stochastic divergence. Okay, so forget the euro. Let's zoom in on the pound. If this channel line breaks, that's going to be confirmed by stochastic divergence. It's going to be confirmed by stochastic crossover. It's going to be confirmed by Bollinger Bands closing, and it'll also be confirmed by a positive channel break. Before we do anything, let's check pivots. And it looks like the central pivot point just happens to be 85.51. Go back to the pound, and it looks like right here price hits 85.50, so it hits the central pivot point and is clearly rejected. Bollinger Bands close, and stochastic divergence sets in, and looks like a channel line may break on a rejection of the central pivot point. So yeah, if this channel breaks, it's down, 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 my friend. Let's see what happens. There's the break. Channel line has broken. Great angle and separation is formed on the stochastics. First target would be the 200 EMA. Second target using pivot points. Let's see. S1 is 85.05. So S1 at 85.05 is the first conservative target. And then M1 is 84.63. Whew, that's a long ways away. I'm going to say a double bottom is going to be the first aggressive target. Let's call that around 84.80. Okay, so here's the goal. You can take your pips and run if you hit the 200 EMA. If it still looks good and we still have good angle and separation on the stochastics, then I want you to hold tight and aim for 85.05. If that can break and we still have good angle and separation, then we're going for the aggressive target of the 84.80 area, which is a double bottom. Okay, let's see what happens from here. Boom. Price is riding the 5. Almost made it to the 200 EMA. Great angle and separation on the 5.8. What happens now? 200 under attack. 200 broken. Wow. Boom. Okay, first goal of 85.05 has been reached. So if you're in around 30, 35, yeah, looks like you got about 30 pips. If you're still in this, this went down to 84.90. Will it reach 84.80? Don't know. You're going to have to keep your eyes on the stochastics. Riding a 5. Ooh. Okay. We're out. Why are we out? Stochastics have crossed back up. That is a clear time to exit this downtrend. It doesn't mean the downtrend's over. What it means is it's run out of steam. So the trade plan for the day was to trade a break of the channel with stochastic divergence, with a stochastic crossover at 25 after a rejection of the central pivot point, aiming for S1 at 85.05 with an aggressive target of 84.80 based on a double bottom. And then we ended up getting out around, not 85, maybe closer to 90 because of a stochastic cross in an oversold position. So somewhere about 85.85 to 85.90, we're out. Looks like about 40 pip profit. And you know, congratulations to all of those that were able to capture on that move. Today is July 24th, 2006, and this has been your daily video technical briefing by FX Bootcamp.